Hello everybody, this is Shilpi Saxena. Welcome to my channel Learning Hub. So today we are going to learn about online classes. Now it's a lockdown period and most of the schools and colleges are conducting online classes. So we can use Zoom app to conduct online class. So we can use it through mobile also and through laptop or desktop also. So here I will tell you how you can use it by using laptop or desktop. So first of all, you have to open a browser and you have to write zoom.us. Zoom.us is the website. Once you open the website, you have to sign in. You can see here, sign in option is there. Here, this is the sign in option. When you will click on this sign in option, so there are, you can see using email address also. You can sign in using Facebook also. Using Google also. So I have used my Facebook account to sign in. You can use your Google account also. You can create a new account also. So it will be, now it will ask, so Facebook will ask you to open Zoom. So you have to click on yes. Here it has opened it directly because already I logged in using Facebook. So it will ask for the permission and then you have to click on yes, then only it will open Zoom. So once it's open, you have to schedule the meeting. Meeting means you, if you want the class to be conducted, you have to schedule the meeting. You can see here, schedule a meeting. The option is there. You have to click here. Once you will click here, you can see the topic is written. This is the meeting room. So this, the topic is written. Suppose I have written demo class. So description of meeting, it is optional. If you want, you can write the topic description, learning Zoom. After that, you can select the date. Whatever date you want, you can select the date and time. I'll just scroll up. Now you can see here, this, you can see May, whatever. Suppose I have selected 12th May. You can see the format of date. It's 12th May. So this is the format which you can use for date and time, and then the time of the meeting. You have to select the time. After that, there is an option of selecting timing, 1 hour, 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. See, when you are using paid version, that is the paid version of Zoom, there is no time limitation. You can select 2 hours, 3 hours, or whatever you feel like. But when we are using basic version, we are not using pro version. If you are using basic version, even if you are selecting 2 hours, it will be for 40 minutes. You can see here it is written 40 minutes. After 40 minutes, the thing is, after 40 minutes, the meeting will automatically end. But if you want to continue with the meeting, so once the meeting end, ask your students to join using the same link again. Using the same link, they can rejoin, which I used to do. Means after 40 minutes, the meeting will get disconnected, and using the same link, which will be shared to the students, they can rejoin the meeting for next 40 minutes. Next thing is, this is recurring meeting. If you want, if you will click on it, it will ask recurring means repetitive meeting. It will be repeated daily or it will be repeated weekly. So I am removing recurring meeting. Suppose it is non-recurring. After that, see, you have initially it was not require meeting password was disabled. So means it can be disabled initially, but nowadays due to excessive usage of Zoom has made mandatory to have a password due to security. So this is the password, and then if you want you can click on host video on. Host is the person, like if I have a schedule, I am the host. If I want, I can make it off, and afterwards we can on the video. It's not an issue. And participant video on. Next thing is enable join before host. This will enable the participants will be able to join the meeting at the time defined before you join. So I prefer it to be unchecked because we should not allow students to join before we start meeting. Mute participants on entry. It will automatically mute the students. They will, whatever background noises, it can distract you if you are teaching. So mute participants upon entry. Enable waiting room. Very important feature. Please check it so that students cannot join directly. if you will allow, then only they will be allowed to join. See, nowadays unknown person can also, if they have your meeting ID, they can join your meeting. So to prevent that, use waiting room so that if an unidentified person joins the meeting, so you can just stop them in waiting room only. Record meeting, it will enable us to record the meeting. Record the meeting, whatever session you have taken, it will be automatically recorded in your drive, and then you can click on save. Once it is saved, if you want to share, so you can see here the link is generated. Come down, invite link. See, invite link. You have to click on copy invitation. This is the invitation generated. You can copy this. See, copy meeting invitation. After that, once you have copied the meeting invitation, you can go to your email, or even you can use your WhatsApp, or you can use your email, gmail.com, and you can mail it to the participants. So whatever participants, you can mail to all the participants whom you like to join in the meeting. So I will just paste it. This is the link which is generated. Suppose I will mail it to myself only. And send. You can see I have received the mail. And you now it was not pasted properly. Now here you can see the link is there. And by clicking on this link, students will be directed to the meeting directly. So this is the meeting ID and this is the password. By using meeting ID and password, they will be able to join the meeting. So when as a participant, when suppose you are a participant and you want to join the meeting, in that case again you have to go to zoom.us. see, I'm again writing zoom.us. After that, see, when you are joining as a participant, there is no need to log in. Directly you can go to join a meeting without logging in, without sign in. And then whatever ID I showed you, there was a ID and password. Whatever ID you are putting here, you will be able to put the ID here and click on join. It will ask for the password. So whatever password is there, you have to click on the password. Like for example, I'll just show my ID. Just a minute, I'll show you how you can join. You have to just enter the ID generated. Suppose my ID is 87 58 69 1140 1140. It's 1140. So you will click on join. So it will ask you to open Zoom. Once you will open Zoom, the host should start meeting. Otherwise, it will display the message waiting for hosts to start the meeting. So you will not be able to join till your host has started the meeting. Now the next thing is it is just getting started. You can see meeting ID. I have not entered the valid ID. Otherwise, it would have shown that waiting for host to start the meeting because the host has not yet started. Now, as a host, now you have scheduled the meeting on that particular day. Suppose you want to start the meeting. This is your account. You have to go to your account. See, this is your account. Now, here you will go to the meeting. And see, your meeting, upcoming meetings, all the meetings will be shown here. Whatever meeting you want to start, just click on start and it will start the meeting. See, it will ask you to open Zoom and it will start the meeting. So you can see here the meeting is started, and joined with computer audio you have to click. Now it will, you can see the meeting has started. So it is not necessary that if you have scheduled the meeting for tomorrow, you can click on the link today also and get your meeting started. Now here you can see this is here your video will be displayed. If you want, you can start your video. If you want, you can mute yourself. And when the participants will join, you will get the list of participants. Here I don't have any participants, so you will not be able to see any participants. So in this way you can start the meeting and finally end meeting for all to close the meeting. Now the next thing is, every time you are scheduling your meeting, new ID and password is generated. Suppose I don't want new meeting ID to be generated. If suppose in a college or a school we have a date sheet or timetable according to which my time falls on Tuesday and Friday. So on that particular day, if a student wants, so I can fix my meeting ID and I can fix my password. So only once I have to share the meeting ID and password, and every time using that meeting ID and password, the student can join. So you don't have to schedule it again and again. For that, you have to go to meeting. And initially we were scheduling the meeting, rather than schedule, you can use personal meeting room. So in personal meeting room, you can see here, I have this personal meeting ID. So you can change the password here. I have made it 12345. You can change the meeting password, and this is fixed. This meeting ID and password is fixed. So when you want to start the meeting, so these are the settings. Whatever settings you have done, these settings are fixed. See, you can change the setting, no problem, but once you have changed here, every time you don't have to change while you are starting the meeting. This is your by default settings. You can change, there are options which you can change, but once you are changing, it will allow you to fix that settings. You want to start the meeting, you can just click on the start and start the meeting. So benefit of using this is your meeting ID and password will be always same. So in this way you can you use Zoom to start the meeting. So in my next video I will discuss how you can secure your account, what security measures you should take while taking a Zoom meeting, and what are the features which we can use to just enhance your teaching. So if you like this video, please like and subscribe, hit the bell icon. Don't forget to share. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.